Hello everyone, I am Chandrakant Rathod, working as Assistant Professor in Mechanical Engineering Department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are going to start a new topic, that is Introduction to Brazing Process and its Applications. Coming to the learning outcomes, at the end of today's lecture, you are able to understand what is brazing process and the application of brazing process. Coming to the content, so following topic will be discussed in this video lecture, that is introduction of brazing, principles of brazing, brazing flux and filler metals, types of brazing, application of brazing, and advantages and limitations of brazing process. Now, coming to the introduction to the brazing process, brazing is a metal joining process in which two or more metals atoms are joined together by melting and flowing a filler metal into the joint, the filler metal having a lower melting point than the adjoining metals. So you can see the diagram. In this one, you are going to see job 1 and job 2. So in between these two, job and job 2, we have to join these two metals. So for joining this one, we are going to require the flux and a high temperature flame. So that flame is taken from the welding torch and filler metal is applied in between the two base metals, that is job 1 and job 2. And then the high temperature flame is applied in between the both the job to melt the flux. Hence the flux will going to melt and the join will going to take place in between the two jobs. So coming to the principles of the brazing. So there are two types of brazing process, that is brazing and braze welding. So first we will going to discuss what is brazing. So brazing is a liquid solid state metal joining process in which filler metal is placed in between the metal surface to be joined and heated so as to melt only filler metal. The filler metal used melts above 450 degrees Celsius. The molten filler metal fills the joint cavity by capillary action and joining takes place by allowing air diffusing process. So coming to the braze welding. Braze welding is a process in which the filler metal is deposited at the joint using a technique similar to oxyacetylene gas welding. Thus, it is similar to any fusion welding operation. The joint is formed by depositing the molten filler metal rather than the capillary action. Hence, it is require more similar metals than brazing. Also, a strong joint can be formed in braze welding since the joint is thicker. However, the melting temperature are lower in braze welding than in fusion welding. Generally, braze uses a filler metal is CuZn alloy, that is brass. You can see this diagram. So as in the introduction also I explained the procedure how the welding takes place in between the two jobs. So let us consider these two jobs. So first, before going to start the apply the our flux, we're going to clean all the dirts and grease on the surface of the both the job. And then we will going to apply the flux, and after applying the flux, we will going to give the high temperature flame through the welding torch. So you are going to see the a flame is created in between these two jobs, and only the flux is going to melt between the two jobs, and not only the our jobs will not going to melt. So you can see the filler metal in between the two jobs is placed. And you can see the job 1 and job 2, and a high temperature flame is produced from the welding torch. So this is how we're going to join the two base metals by the brazing process. So coming to this diagram, second diagram, you're going to see there are two base metals. You will going to see the lap joint in between the two base metals, and in between that one, base metal 1 and base metal 2, so there is a filler metal you are going to see. So from that one, the filler metal is melted by using the high temperature flame that is given by the gas starch. And in the second diagram, you are going to see the weld bead is formed by the brazed welding. So that is the cross section of the our lap joint base metals. So there you can see the weld bead is formed by the brazing, and hence the joint is takes place in between the two jobs. So coming to the brazing flux and filler metals. So first we are going to see brazing flux. So similar to the welding, a thin film of metal flux is filled in the metal to be joined. In brazing, metal oxide and other surface coating like dirt, grease, whatever they are present on the metal surface, that affects the bonding quality. Hence, flux is used to dissolve the oxide film and reacts with the surface coating to form a slag and protect the surface. Generally used brazing flux are made up of chemicals like borax, boric acid, borate and chlorides. For brazing at lower temperature, fluoride of the alkaline metals are used. For brazing copper alloys with high phosphorus, there is no need for the flux. So coming to the filler metals, the term brazing usually refers to the uses of brass, that is copper and zinc alloy, as the filler material to produce the joints. Brass with various composition is widely used to produce ductile joints in the steels, which is the most common commercial application. Brass used as a filler material generally contains less than 60% of copper. So, certain alloying elements like silicon, silver, nickel and magnesium are also added to the brass to attain the desirable properties in the joints. Now pause the video. Which is the flux used for brazing process? I hope you have written the answer. The flux which is used for brazing process is borax, boric acid, borate and chlorides. So coming to the type of brazing, so there are different types of brazing process are as follows. So we are going to discuss starch brazing, furnace brazing, induction brazing, salt bath brazing, dip brazing and resistance brazing. So we are going to discuss one by one. So first we are going to consider the starch brazing. The starch brazing is the mostly used method, especially where the process is jobbing in nature and when the assembly is very large. Generally, heat is produced by burning oxyacetylene gas. It gives a high temperature and hence more suitable for brazing process. So coming to the furnace brazing. Furnace brazing is suitable for brazing large number of small to medium sized components, usually brazing metals in the granular form or as a strip are placed at the joint and then the assembly is fed to the furnace. The furnace used may be either a batch type or a continuous type. We are going to take the furnace brazing. So coming to the induction brazing. In this method, heat is produced by passing a high frequency current through the coil placed around the workpiece. The high frequency current induces eddy current in the surface of metals. So coming to the salt bath brazing, in this process, a salt bath is used as the source of heat and flux for the brazing. The parts to be joined are assembled and placed with a strip or a wire of brazing alloy at the line of joints, and the assembly is dipped in the salt bath, which melts brazing alloy and fills the joints by capillary action. The joint is get solidified as the part is taken out of the bath. So coming to the application of the brazing. So there are many applications are used in the welding process to join the two base metals. So one we are going to discuss, brazing is used where a tough and a ductile joint is required. So wherever the tough joint is required, the brazing process is used to join the two base metals. So coming to the second application, brazing also used in for joining the steels, cast iron, bronze and brass. So you're going to see this brazing is also used for the joining the cast iron, bronze and brasses. So coming to the advantages and limitations of the brazing. First we're going to discuss the advantages. It is the simplest and fastest process for joining electrical connections. As we know that nowadays all the connections is used joined by the brazing process, and this brazing process is used to join the electrical connections. So any two dissimilar metal forming an inert metal compounding with a tin carbon can be joined. So it is suitable for both manual and automatic applications. So this brazing is useful for manually joining the metal, two base metals, and automatically also we can join the two base metals. So it is also suitable for mass production. In industry, we are going to consider that there is a mass production, then there will going to we'll going to use the brazing process. So coming to the limitations of our brazing process, it is not suitable for the structural joints. As we know that in the structural joint, so there is a more load is applied, more pressure is created in the structural joint. So for that reason, we are not going to use this brazing process as the in the structural joints. So it is suitable only for the low strength and thin joints. So you can see the wherever the low strength and thin joint is required, they're only going to we're going to use this one. These joints are not suitable for vibration and corrosion environments. As we know that wherever the more vibration is there, so there will not going to use this brazing process, and wherever the more corrosive environment is there will not going to use this brazing process. So these are the some references which is taken for this lecture, that is manufacturing technology by P. N. Rao and manufacturing process by one, that is A. C. Niranjan. Thank you.